Now that you understand the basics of the workflow, it is time to check out a tool called Building Maker. Building Maker helps you create low-poly buildings by making the tasks and procedures you just learned about even easier. It combines all the needed functionality inside an intuitive, easy-to-use interface. Keep in mind that Building Maker is not a city generator, as some of the available commercial products are. It is only meant as a fast alternative to create buildings by extruding splines and assigning materials in an easy and intuitive way. I designed and conceived the workflow behind Building Maker, but it was written in Mac script by my co-worker Martin Ashton. Martin is our in-house Mac script guru and has helped me before on many occasions. Thank you, Martin, for your help yet again. To run Building Maker, simply use Mac script run script. Locate the buildingmaker.ms file and run it. The interface is very straightforward and is meant to appeal to all users of 3ds Max, irrespective of their level of expertise. Close or minimize Building Maker. You'll come back to it in a moment. Open the file cityblocks-buildings-bmakerstart.max. It shows the same familiar city block you worked on in the last few movies. To use Building Maker, first you need some 2D footprints. As before, you can create them directly in 3ds Max, or if you have a few ready in CAD software, you can import them into your current scene. Use the Import tool to import the file named footprints.dwg that you downloaded for this tutorial. This is a simple AutoCAD file with multiple 2D shapes drawn to represent building footprints. When you import the file into 3ds Max, you get a dialog with various options. Note the default option that says that objects are derived by the layer they are on. This effectively means that all objects on the same layer come in as a single object in 3ds Max. This method works in most scenarios, but not in this one, as you need to access the 2D shapes individually. Use the Entity option instead. Under Geometry options, make sure the Weld Nearby Vertices option is enabled, as you need to deal with closed polylines. If the important 2D shapes are not closed, you will have a hard time capping extrusions. Click OK to dismiss the dialog and import the footprints. There are many, and if you press H to access the Select from Scene dialog, you'll notice they all have the same name. Go ahead and select all polylines in the list that bear the same name. You need to rename them to ensure they have individual names for Building Maker to work properly. With the shape selected, use the Rename Objects dialog to give a base name to the splines. Use the base name BM, that stands for Building Maker, -FP underscore, footprints underscore, and enable Numbered with a base number of 1. This ensures the splines are named BMFP01, BMFP02, and so on. If you prefer to have 3 digits, you can use the base name BM-FP_0 instead. You may need to revisit the Rename tool if and when you have more than 100 shapes, though. Dismiss the Rename dialog when done, and create a new selection set named Footprints to make selection easier. Always remember to press Enter after specifying a selection set name. In AutoCAD, all these shapes were created at Z level 0. However, in 3ds Max, the building blocks levels are 0.15 meters off the ground. And so, make sure you move all the shapes a relative 0.15 meter displacement in Z. You're now ready to use Building Maker on any of these footprints. Some are simple, others are more complex, representing buildings that have multiple footprints. Since this is your first time using Building Maker, you will use it to reproduce the same brick building you built manually earlier. Zoom in on the corner lot and open Building Maker again. The left side of the window has the functionality to build various levels in a building hierarchy. The right side lets you edit various parameters. To create a building, you start appropriately by using the Create Building button and then picking a 2D spline. This creates a volume representing the building's street level, which you can now adjust to your liking. For example, there are options to manage the start and end capping of the extrusion. More importantly, you want to assign textures and materials to fit that level. Instead of going to the material editor and fiddle with material types and map nodes, all is done from within the Building Maker interface. To assign a color texture, simply click the Browse Color Map button. Browse and select the same ground level texture you used for the brick building in earlier movies. Similarly, browse and select the matching reflection map. Building Maker follows the principle you have learned about before and also works in real-world dimensions. This means that you need to enter the real-world dimensions of the texture you are using, which is shown in the file name. If you use your own textures, it is recommended you include that information in the file names. As you define the width and height values, the extruded volume automatically adjusts. If you need to nudge the image position, you can offset it in one of three directions. In this case, the slide Z offset works well. To create another level above this one, use the Add New Level button. The building switches to X-ray mode to make spline selection easier. Pick the same spline, as this building only has one footprint. A new volume is created above the previous one. Incidentally, there are two buttons to toggle X-ray mode and wireframe mode. This is roughly the same as using Alt-X and F3. Now that you have a new volume for repetitive typical floors, go ahead and select the correct textures for them. Adjust the real-world dimensions accordingly. Here, you may want to alter the number of repetitive floors in the building. To that extent, use the height multiplier value. This adds any number of floors without distorting the textures or mapping coordinates. Use Add New Level again to add the penthouse. Make the necessary adjustments to the textures and possibly the Z offset value. To create the roof, start by adding a new level for the gravel surface. Make sure you cap the end part to get a flat area. Apply a gravel texture that you like. Note that the dirt textures do not have a real-world dimension set in the file name. That's because you have a bit of leeway in textures like dirt, sand, and grass, as far as real-world dimensions are concerned. Set this one to about 10 meters by 10 meters, and then reduce the height multiplier value to create a thin slab. You still need a parapet to go around the roof, and it needs to be at the same level as the dirt texture. With the gravel slab selected, use the Add New Element button to add the parapet. You now have two volumes or elements at the same elevation, right above the penthouse. Zoom in and notice the flicker, where the new volume and the gravel slab are fighting one another for display priority. This is because their side polygons are sharing the same vertical planes. You can change that by making the parapet protrude a bit using the Start Width or End Width options. To make the volume look like a parapet, enable the Level 1 and Level 2 options. This is the same as adjusting the levels on a bevel modifier. You can even remove the end cap for the parapet, as you are meant to see the gravel surface. For simple diffuse color, use the appropriate color swatch and define a color or pick one from the scene. The nice thing about Building Maker is that the building hierarchy is preserved at all times. This means if you decide to change the number of typical floors, for example, all floors above are automatically adjusted. By the same token, you can edit the base spline and all dependent floors adjust to that change. On that note, if the base splines are imported from other applications, chances are the individual segments are set in line mode. This prevents you from creating curved walls. This is an easy fix, though. All you need is to select all segments that make the base and turn them into curve mode. From that point on, You can use Bezier handles on vertices and run with your imagination. Save your file. In the next movie, you explore a bit more of Building Maker's functionality.